Thank you, Mr. President. I'm really pleased to join my colleagues, Senator Cardin and earlier Senator Murray, this morning in commemorating International Women's Day. It's a day observed around the world, and it celebrates the economic, political, and social achievements of women, past, present, and future. It's a day which recognizes the obstacles that women still face in the struggle for equal rights and equal opportunities. 1 year ago today, I, along with a group of bipartisan senators, introduced and passed a resolution in the Senate recognizing the significance of the 100th anniversary of International Women's Day. Today's the 101st anniversary, and like the centennial milestone before it, it is a testament to the dedication and determination of women and men around the world to address gender inequality for the good of all people. There are more than 3.3 billion women in the world today. And across the globe, women are participating in the political, social, and economic life of their communities in an unprecedented fashion, playing a critical role in providing and caring for their families, contributing substantially to the growth of economies, and advancing food security for their communities. Yesterday, I had the wonderful, humbling, and inspiring opportunity to recognize and celebrate the 10 recipients of the 2012 State Department International Women of Courage Awards. This prestigious award, which is the only award in the State Department given only to women, annually recognizes women who have shown exceptional courage and leadership in advocating for women's rights and empowerment around the globe, often at significant risk to themselves. These award winners, including activists in the Sudan and Saudi Arabia, politicians in Turkey and Afghanistan, and representatives from six other countries, are truly remarkable and inspirational women. And, Mr. President, I would like to submit all of their names and brief bios for the record so that they're properly recognized by the Senate.
Without objection.
Thank you. This morning, I want to pick just one of these amazing women and tell her story. Shad Begum is the executive director of the Union of Women's Welfare in one of the most extremely conservative districts in all of Pakistan. As the founder and executive director of the program, the Union of Women's Welfare, she provides political training, microcredit, primary education, and health services to women throughout her community. She not only encouraged others to run for office, she herself ran for a district councilor seat in 2001 and 2005, winning the seat against local conservatives who tried to ban women from participating. Despite numerous threats to her life and her family, including calls for suicide attacks against her by local extremists, she continues to work to improve the lives of women throughout Pakistan. Ms. Shad is one of 10 remarkable women that the State Department honored this year. And every one of their 10 stories is inspirational. But they represent literally millions of women around the globe who are out there fighting and suffering to be heard. There are countless women who don't receive recognition that they deserve, who continue to be silenced by persecution and harassment, and today, we recognize, honor, and celebrate all of those nameless, faceless women around the world who are continuing the fight. Far too many women remain excluded from full participation in society to the detriment of their communities, their countries, and the world. And although strides have been made in recent decades, women across the globe continue to face significant obstacles in all aspects of their lives, including the denial of basic human rights, discrimination, and gender-based violence. According to the World Bank, women make up 70% of all individuals living in poverty. Women account for 64% of the adults worldwide who lack basic literacy skills. Women continue to remain vastly underrepresented in national and local governments around the world. So there's no doubt that we have a lot of work to do. But all of society benefits when women are more fully integrated into their communities and their villages around the world. In the words of President Obama, our common prosperity will be advanced by allowing all humanity, men and women, to reach their full potential. As we reflect on the past, present, and future achievements of women, I think it's important to recognize the vital and untapped resource that women represent for our world. The ability of women to realize their full potential is critical to the ability of a nation to achieve strong and lasting economic growth, political and social stability, and enhanced security for all its people. Thank you very much, Mr. President. I yield the floor and note the absence of a quorum.